Look, what if I told you there was something you were missing? What if I told you that Jesus doesn't really fit into your description? What if I told you that follower of Christ doesn't automatically mean Christian, and just because you believe in faith doesn't mean Jesus didn't believe in submission and conviction? Listen. You say Jesus was God and that God had descended. We say Jesus was man, for Jesus was dependent. Watch. Islamic concept of Jesus, Islamic concept of God, the verse of the throne, Surah Baqarah, verse 255. Allah, la ilaha illa huwa, none has the right to be worshipped but He, the ever-living, the one who sustains and protects all that exists. Neither slumber nor sleep overtakes Him. To Him belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is on earth. Who is He that can intercede with Him except with His permission? He knows what happens to them, His creatures, in this world, and what will happen to them in the hereafter. And they will never comprehend anything of His knowledge except that which He wills. His kursi, throne, extends over the heavens and the earth, and He feels no fatigue in guarding and preserving them. And He is the High, the Most Great. Our God is all great and cannot be comprehended. You say that God was murdered, or do you believe that He pretended? See, God gave us brains and God gave us logic, but I guess God wanted us to use them in everything else except for this topic. It's like wearing a cross and proclaiming that you love Jesus, when if God was murdered on the cross really shouldn't please us. I mean, would you be wearing an axe if it was used to chop your mother up into pieces? See, this is what happens when you believe in faith but fail to believe in reason. See, we used to worship the Creator until Satan turned us to the creation. We began to worship the people and neglect the one who made them. We began to believe that God had died, but how could a God even be created? A miraculous birth, and therefore the Son of God was begotten. See, the creation of Jesus was easy, but you seem to have forgotten that God says be, watch. Holy Quran, Surah Ali Imran, Family of Imran, 359, verily, the likeness of Isa, Jesus, before Allah is the likeness of Adam. He created him from dust, then, He, said to him, be, and he was, and it is, just like with Adam, a concept too complex for the church to merely fathom, for he was the creator of the universe, for all we know even more. And so what if we can't see him? I mean, what you acting like our universe is small? I mean, there is still so much we're still yet to explore. I mean, there are still so many things as human beings we still haven't seen, touched, heard or saw. I mean, our eyes can't even handle the sight of the sun, so how can we possibly handle the sight of our Lord? See, Jesus used to pray, read Gospel of Matthew 26:39, and he went a little further, and fell on his face, and prayed, saying, O my Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me, nevertheless not as I will, but as thou wilt. But in your opinion, who did he pray to? I mean, if Jesus was God, surely prayer would be of no use, or did he only require it when he needed to know the truth, like when God wasn't sure whether it was the season of the fruit? Gospel of Mark 11:12-14, and on the morrow, when they were come from Bethany, he was hungry, and seeing a fig tree afar off having leaves, he came, if haply he might find anything thereon, and when he came to it, he found nothing but leaves, for the time of figs was not yet. And Jesus answered and said unto it, No man eat the fruit of thee hereafter forever. And his disciples heard it. I said not to them except what you commanded me, to worship Allah, my Lord, and your Lord. And I was a witness over them as long as I was among them, but when you took me up, you were the observer over them, and you are, over all things, witness. If you should punish them, indeed they are your servants, but if you forgive them, indeed it is you who is the exalted in might, the wise. Allah will say, this is the day when the truthful will benefit from their truthfulness. For them are gardens in paradise beneath which rivers flow, wherein they will abide forever, Allah being pleased with them, and they with Him. That is the great attainment. To Allah belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth and whatever is within them. And He is over all things competent, And I mean, you don't have to be that dumb to know that 1 plus 1 plus 1 equaling 1 isn't necessarily gonna give you a pass in mathematics. See, the church said 3 when Jesus said 1. Watch, was Jesus the Son of God? You decide. Jesus said God when the church said Son. Jesus never said worship me, rather he said pray, watch. Book of Matthew 6-6, but thou, when thou prayest, enter into thy closet, and when thou hast shut thy door, pray to thy Father which is in secret, and thy Father which seeth in secret shall reward thee openly. But you've chosen to worship Jesus, despite everything he used to say. You began to think with your emotion and forgot to think with your mind. I guess you didn't pay attention when Jesus says our Father yet never says mine, watch. Book of Matthew 6-9 NB, this video is private. After this manner, therefore, pray ye, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. You claim to be a follower of Christ yet you still choose to eat swine, watch. The book of Deuteronomy 14:8, and the swine, because it divideth the hoof, yet cheweth not the cud, it is unclean unto you, ye shall not eat of their flesh, nor touch their dead carcass. And you call yourselves Christians, but in your churches, you're busy drinking wine, watch. The book of Leviticus 10:9-11, do not drink wine nor strong drink, thou, nor thy sons with thee, when ye go into the tabernacle of the congregation, lest ye die. It shall be a statute forever throughout your generations, and that ye may put difference between holy and unholy, and between unclean and clean, and that ye may teach the children of Israel all the statutes which the Lord hath spoken unto them by the hand of Moses. And just to clarify, I do love Jesus. Matter of fact, I love him more than you, because when Jesus said do something, I actually do. However, I'm not connected with the church nor with the Bible. See, I love Jesus as my prophet, but refused to worship him as an idol just like he wanted, and proclaimed it as sin. Read the book of Exodus 24, thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. So it doesn't really matter if they don't let him in, because Jesus wouldn't even want to be in the presence of people worshiping an idol of him. Voiceover. Statue torched, Monroe, an act of God, a bolt of lightning went straight through the outstretched hand of Jesus. This cannot be. But before I move on, there's something I need to mention. The worshiping of Jesus, voiceover. Giant Jesus is no more. Is a man-made invention. He never asked for your worship so he can grant you protection. Rather, he asked you to alternate your prayers towards another direction, voiceover. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. God is the greatest. God is the greatest, to God and God only, and pray that he accepts them. And know that just because you love Jesus doesn't mean he feels the same way about your affection. See, what you believe in is exactly what he resented. Matter of fact, it's everything he despised. See, the worshiping of creation goes against the very message he supplied. So you began to follow a religion and called it love in disguise, because love can be good, but love can be blind.
Fire spread as fast as the flames. Within minutes, a big crowd gathered at the base of the statue, some very emotional, taking this as some sort of sign from up above, others glad to see it gone.
This cannot be a coincidence. This is something that we all have to go on our face as the church and pray and ask for forgiveness and repent from every sin in our lives so that God himself will come back.
We worship Jesus. We worship God. And we need to come together as a church and start fasting and praying and see what we're missing together as a church.
Glad Touchdown Jesus is in ashes now.
So you hope they don't rebuild it?
Well, he's got a lot of money and he likes it. It's his church. His wife likes it, so he'll probably rebuild it. More power to him. I'm just glad I don't have to look at this one for a while.
The church is already saying Jesus will rise from these ashes, and this time he'll be bigger and better. This one was well grounded, but it was also made of highly flammable styrofoam wrapped in fiberglass. Everyone looking at this devastation is trying to find some meaning in the ruins.
I think it's the Lord telling us that it's about Him and not about images that we can make of Him.